What is the relationship between consciousness and the physical world? Can mind influence matter? And if so, what could this tell us about the nature of reality? In this video, we'll explore how a small number of scientists have investigated the relationship between consciousness and matter, and how controversial experiments spanning nearly a century have produced surprising evidence that our minds have a mysterious influence on the world. The first studies, led by J.B. Rhein in the 1930s, were basic by today's standards. They investigated to see if people could influence the outcomes of simple random events, like dice throws or coin flips, using no more than their directed mental intention. These mind-matter experiments appeared to show that random processes could be mysteriously influenced by human intention. While positive and statistically significant results were reported, the findings were controversial, and skeptical scientists rejected the work of Rhein and his colleagues. In the 1970s, the physicist Helmut Schmidt attempted to replicate the effect using a more rigorous scientific protocol. He also designed the first truly random number generator, or RNG. Schmidt's early RNG derived its random coin flip from the release of electrons from a piece of weakly radioactive material. These quantum events are inherently probabilistic and were used by Schmidt as the source of a truly random event. He converted this random process into a ring of light that would light up in either a clockwise or counterclockwise direction, depending on the behavior of the RNG. Using only their mental intention, Schmidt instructed his participants to intend that the lights move in a particular direction, depending on the experimental condition. Schmidt reported that even at a distance, when participants mentally intended to influence the RNG, its outputs actually changed to go slightly more in the direction of their intention. The effect was very small, but over many experimental trials, the results became highly statistically significant. It was as if the minds of the participants were somehow introducing order into the otherwise random physical process.
It looks like a small effect, but we did the experiments long enough that we could say it was not chance anymore. These people were not lucky. It was a real systematic effect. So from the basic viewpoint, there is something which is inconsistent with physics.
After multiple successful studies, Schmidt became convinced that the mind-matter effect was real. Another notable study with an identical design was later carried out at the prestigious Bell Labs by psychologist Dean Radin. These, however, were just the beginning of what would become a series of successful replications of this mysterious phenomenon. Over the next 30 years, the most extensive research into this effect took place at the Princeton Engineering Anomalies Research Laboratory, also known by the acronym PEAR. These studies were led by physicist Robert Jahn and psychologist Brenda Dunne. They developed a more advanced RNG using quantum tunneling as its source of true randomness. When their participants intended an RNG to produce more high or low counts, the statistical outputs were often seen to depart from their ordinary random behavior, producing outputs that were more in line with the participants' pre-stated intentions. Over nearly three decades, researchers at Princeton ran hundreds of thousands of trials. They reported positive evidence of a mind-matter effect associated with odds against chance of greater than a trillion to one. Other experiments using RNGs were carried out by researchers at the Institute of Noetic Sciences. Not only did their findings support the previous studies, they found that sudden changes in mental states and shared emotions also appeared to influence RNGs. This field phenomenon had also been observed by the researchers at Princeton. Researchers began taking RNGs to events where large groups of people were engaged in a similar focus of attention, like sports events, mass meditations, and theatrical performances. researchers found that the RNGs they took with them were often seen to depart from their ordinary random behavior at the precise times when group attention was expected to be at a peak. The Global Consciousness Project, led by Princeton psychologist Radin Nelson, took this idea to a planetary scale, setting up a worldwide network of RNGs. Nelson predicted that global events, which captured the attention of entire populations, might produce detectable departures from randomness across this global network of RNGs. Over two decades, some 500 globally significant events were recorded, including New Year's celebrations, terrorist attacks, and natural disasters. Many of these events were associated with a significant increase in statistical order occurring in the network. Together, the likelihood that these results are due to chance is now also reported to be less than a trillion to one. Perhaps the most striking example of a possible global consciousness effect occurred on September the 11th, 2001. As a series of shocking terrorist attacks gripped the attention of billions of minds, Nelson's network of RNGs made a series of dramatic departures from their baseline random behavior. On the day of these world-changing events, the RNGs comprising the Global Consciousness Project became mysteriously synchronized, producing the single largest intercorrelation value of any day that year.
A question tonight, can you actually measure the emotional outpouring in a worldwide crisis?
Sometimes scientists think that they have done just that. Their machines and computers found a bizarre pattern right after several global disasters.
CBS News' Brendan Keefe explains this phenomenon.
September 11th deeply affected people far beyond New York and Washington. The attack sent shockwaves around the world, a global reaction that triggered a spike in a network of scientific instruments, just like a seismograph during an earthquake. It may sound bizarre, but Dr. Nelson and his team have been at this for the better part of a decade. The first spike showed up in 1997 with the death of Princess Diana. Other events like the Concorde crash, the Madrid train bombing, and the Pope's funeral all registered on those random number generators. But early on the morning of September 11th, the data went off the charts.
How these effects occur and what they mean remains mysterious. And yet, a large number of studies indicate that where attention and intention go, order mysteriously flows. The mind-matter research hints to the existence of an important relationship between consciousness and the physical world. It appears to suggest that the ancient belief that mind occupies a fundamental place in reality could have a basis in truth. Hi everyone, I hope you found that interesting. This is an area of research that I looked into quite deeply several years ago. Back then, I met and interviewed many of the scientists involved in these experiments, and I became fairly convinced that these mind-matter effects are a real phenomenon. It is certainly a controversial area of research, and it's probably not surprising that these findings have not been more broadly accepted by scientists. There have been, I think, some valid criticisms, but generally I've been satisfied by the responses to those criticisms from the researchers themselves. These findings do appear to challenge various scientific assumptions about the mind and its relationship to the world. But to me, that seems like even more of a reason to really look closely at these studies and try to get to the truth of what might be going on here. At the end of the day, I do think that we should try to keep an open mind even about these more controversial phenomena, because if they are real, they could have very important implications. So it's in that spirit that I made this video introduction to these experiments. and I hope you found it interesting. There's certainly a lot more to say about these studies than I can fit into a short video like this. And so if you are interested, I definitely recommend reading some of the published studies, as well as the replies to the skeptics from the researchers themselves, some of which are referenced in the description of the video. If you would like to go on a deep dive into these experiments, the director of the Global Consciousness Project, Radin Nelson, was a guest on my podcast, and we had a very in-depth conversation about these experiments, the history of the field, and his work on the Global Consciousness Project. Radin is really someone who has spent their entire career working in this field. So if you are interested in these mind-matter experiments, I definitely recommend listening to that conversation. I did have some minor problems with the sound during that episode, but it's all perfectly audible. A link to that should be on the screen towards the end of the video, or you can simply find it in the description below. I am very interested to hear what you all think about this subject. What do you think about these findings? Let me know in the comments and let's have a conversation. Before I say goodbye, please remember that you can support the continued existence of my channel on Patreon at patreon.com/wakingcosmos. And a huge thank you to those of you who are already supporting my work. There is, of course, no obligation to do that, and by far the easiest way to support the channel is to click like, share, and subscribe for more episodes. Okay, that is about it from me. I'm Adrian Nelson. Until next time.